found most of the matter in the universe is made of just three particles. Yo, 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 mga kabayo, what's up, Ketchup, and welcome to Inai Thank You, our time and space to learn life lessons from lessons about life. So in the last episodes, we talked about the tools and the methods to help us understand nature, and also, you know, a few recommendations to help you get started with a few YouTube channels. And I can't wait to introduce you to the first tool that we will be unlocking. It's the first of the five natural sciences, and that is chemistry. Teka, di ba bio major ka? So, but hindi na lang tayo mag-plants and animals? It's hard to talk about very complicated systems such as ourselves, our bodies, you know, whatever is going on inside us, if we don't break it down into the very basic parts. It's like me asking you to talk about a car without saying any part. At all, without mentioning any part. See if you can do that. It's very difficult because part of how we understand things is by simplifying things into smaller bits and pieces. So ito yung itsura ng table of contents ng iyong standard chemistry college textbook and also your standard college biology textbook. This one is Chemistry the Central Science by Lee May and Brown, and this one is Biology by Campbell and Reese. Biology is always last when you see it in your chemistry book, and chemistry is always first when you see it in your biology book. That's not a coincidence. These books were written by experts, and there's a reason why that is the exact sequence. Take it from them, we will start with chemistry. So, isa sa mga tanong na hanggang ngayon eh, hindi pa rin talaga natin masagot ng todo is, what is the universe made of? And that is what chemistry and physics seek to answer. So chemistry is the study of matter, its properties, and the changes that it goes through. Matter is anything that has mass and takes up space. So it's pretty much everything that we can smell, touch, and taste. Almost everything. Pati tayo. We are matter. This t-shirt, me, my hair, this camera, you, all of these things matter. So to make things simple, let's talk about a piece of bread as our hypothetical matter. Most of us would be happy with that piece of bread. We'd probably eat it and not even really think about it too much. But scientists, boy, their minds are quite something. Is it possible that this is even made of even smaller things? They were right. In fact, much of the matter that we encounter in our everyday lives are actually mixtures of different kinds of matter. Take again your piece of bread. It's made of a mix of flour, salt, water, and yeast. Maybe a bit of sugar and oil, if you feel like it. Yay! So we were able to break them down into even smaller components. It doesn't stop there. They were still curious. Well, could we separate these components into even smaller components? Yes, you can. You find that if you separate these things even further, they're actually made of molecules. So out of these ingredients of your bread, let's take salt, for example, to make it easy. Your salt crystals are made of sodium chloride molecule. May ililiit pa ba to? Apparently, may ililiit pa siya. So if you separate it further into its even something more basic, you end up with atoms. The sodium chloride molecule is made of the atoms sodium and chlorine. Atoms are the building blocks of matter. Tapos na ang kwento. Hindi po. Kasi makulit ang scientists, makulit ang scientific method. They're always out to disprove each other, and they're like, no, there has to be something smaller. And indeed, there is. So upon closer inspection, they found that even atoms are made of even smaller particles, which we now call subatomic particles. A brief description of how atoms sort of look like. They have a nucleus in the center, which is made of two types of subatomic particles, your protons and your neutrons. And then surrounding that nucleus, made of protons and neutrons, electrons that just buzz around pretty close to your nucleus. Wow, even atoms are made of smaller things. And that's pretty much what you might learn from high school chemistry. Then you go to college and realize, wait, there's more. So today, the standard model theory of quantum physics is perhaps the most widely accepted theory that helps explain pretty much what's going on in the universe. They have found that even these subatomic particles are made of smaller particles. Elementary particles can be grouped into just a few basic types. You have quarks, leptons, force carriers. Now, protons and neutrons are apparently made of quarks. Protons are made of 2 up quarks and 1 down quark, and neutrons are made of 2 down quarks and 1 up quark. Hope you got that, but if you didn't, it's okay. The electron, on the other hand, apparently is an elementary particle, a lepton. So pwede nyo siyang inumin because it's lepton iced tea. So we worked our way from big things like bread to the smallest things like quarks and electrons. Let's try to flip it and reverse it. Up quarks plus down quarks equals protons and neutrons. Protons and neutrons plus electrons equals atoms. Atoms plus other atoms equals molecules. Molecules plus other molecules equals mixtures. Mixtures plus other mixtures equals bigger and more complicated things like you, me, plants, animals, mountains, oceans, planets, the stars, and plastic. But how exactly atoms make that all happen? Well, that's something for next time. Today's truth is that most of the matter in the universe is made of just 3 particles. The up quark, the down quark, and lepton, which is the electron. So here's something to think about. Do you think that we are special because we are all so different? Or because we are all the same? How is this blowing your mind right now? And what other life lessons have you learned? So leave it down in the comments below. And as usual, if there's anything else that you would like to learn, I'd like to refer you to these other channels that you can go ahead and watch if your craving for chemistry hasn't been satisfied just yet. Once again, this is Rumble B. I will see you next time. Kita kits mga bagits. And I thank you.